office will be staffed with career members of the Attorney General's office, people who have 7 years or more of experience as a prosecutor. We will have a public corruption tip line so that Rhode Islanders no longer need to turn to the investigative reporters of Channel 10 or Channel 12 or any other news media, print or otherwise. They will know where to take their complaints of public corruption, and they will have an ear that will listen and an attorney general that will follow the trail of public corruption no matter where it leads, whether it's a high elected official or a person with a no-show job. Whether that person is a Democrat, a Republican, an independent, or a moderate, this Attorney General's office will be above public corruption, and I will follow that trail no matter where it leads. But I have included in my legislation the establishment of the Public Corruption Unit so that that task force will be a permanent part of the Attorney General's office, so that in future administrations there will be a legacy of a commitment against public corruption. Because once this bowl starts rolling up the hill, as I will push it with all of my might and all of the might of the talented people in the Attorney General's office, we cannot stop. That ball will roll down back over us if we let up for a single moment, and I will not allow that to happen in our state. I have set forth also in this legislation a provision and requirements for the appointment of a special prosecutor when the Attorney General becomes conflicted. As you may recall, in recent headlines, the investigation in Central Falls, a public corruption investigation ongoing now, where the state police have set up an office in the mayor's office of Central Falls, Mayor Chuck Moreau. On January 25th of this year, when the investigation broke, I understood the conflicts that our current Attorney General faced, both personal and political, ties that would prevent him from carrying out his duties. And I called for him to step aside back in January. I called again for him to step aside in April. That call was responded by the Attorney General in the media as referring to my demand that he step aside as being an irresponsible political attack. 5 days later, Colonel Doherty of the State Police took the courageous step to remove the investigation from the Attorney General's office and to hand it over to the U.S. Attorney's office, as I had called for. But what that process brought to my attention was the fact that even if the Attorney General had chosen the correct path to appoint a special prosecutor, it would have been he, the Attorney General, with the conflict or perceived conflict of interest that himself would have selected the special prosecutor. My statute removes the Attorney General from that process and sets forth a procedure by which the Attorney General's request for a special prosecutor would be forwarded to a three-judge panel made up of the presiding justice of the Superior Court and the chief justices of the Family and District Court to appoint a special prosecutor so that we can be assured in the future that when I or any future Attorney General believes that themselves or the office is conflicted from the handling of a prosecution, that there will be an independent and a trusted group of individuals that can select that prosecutor to go forth and to handle that case to ensure that the people of Rhode Island have before them an individual that will prosecute it to the fullest extent and without any concern of political involvement. These are just a few of the measures that I am setting forth in my fight against public corruption that are encapsulated in this legislation called the HOPE Act. And I will submit this during my first days in administration to the new legislature that will be elected in November, with hope that these are the individuals that will carry forth this fight in the General Assembly. But with it or without it, I make this promise to the people of Rhode Island today, to you, the voters, the taxpayers, the hard-working people of this state, that I will be relentless in pursuing the fight against public corruption, because we can no longer afford it. It not only takes the money from your pocketbooks, from your kitchen tables, but it drives away the businesses that we want to attract here in Rhode Island. No business will locate here No business will provide the jobs that we need now with the unemployment rate where it is, and no jobs for the future when our state is known throughout this country as a pay-to-play state. And furthermore, we cannot expect to retain the businesses that we already have here that are struggling now against so many odds to remain here and to expand here when they are continually faced with the challenges of a corrupt government. We owe this fight to restore the public trust in our government so that it can carry out those limited responsibilities that we expect of our elected officials, our appointed officials, and those who draw pay from you and from every person that writes a check on tax day and who puts their faith in their government to carry out its basic responsibilities. My name is Eric Wallen. I want to be your next Attorney General, and I will fight this fight so long as you give me the opportunity to do it. Please visit my website, Eric Wallen for AG. That's Eric for AG or Wallen for AG, and join our fight today, as I will join you. Thank you very much for your time and for your support.